you know, the pandemic that we're all living in right now has caused this year, obviously, for us not to be able to meet in public gatherings, public worship services like we're so used to. And so because of that, you know, we weren't able to meet. There was a lot of disconnection that happened. At least I feel like it has. I can't definitively say. I have been very pleasantly surprised, however, about the amount of people that have been engaged. And so that's encouraging to me. But because I don't know when this is going to end, I don't know when we're going to get to the place where, you know, we're in phase three and restrictions are lifted and we can all come together again. I don't want to just kind of stall out and miss out or lose out on opportunities to really to connect with our family. That's part of it. The other heavy part of it is being able to effectively disciple and instruct and teach you and to help us to mature and become more mature believers than we've ever been before. This has been a word that's been on my heart since January. This maturing, this growing, this endeavoring to be to get to a level where the Holy Spirit is able to deposit within us deeper truths and greater truths as it relates to the kingdom of God and to the Spirit of the Lord. And so, but to get to that place, there needs to be a maturation process that takes place. And so I've struggled to be able to determine how that could take place. How could that happen? And because of the current events that are happening in our, you know, in our country, you know, the answers become quite easy for us. And so, you know, we're going to start making some adjustments. And so I wanted to kind of just real quick, before I jump into teaching you anything from the Word, two things. Number one, this is the time where we typically receive our tithes and our offerings, and I just want to bless you and encourage you to please be faithful in your giving. Let me just tell you something. I don't know what I said last week, but you guys really stepped it up in your contributions and in your giving, and I'm grateful for that. We are very blessed and fortunate here that over the years since I've been a pastor here, that we were able to pay off our buildings and our property and get that to be in a place where we're debt-free here. But there is still expenses associated with running a ministry. And I know that's not anything really sexy that makes people want to give and be like, yay, let's pay for the lights, or yay, let's pay for the internet. And I heard Tina just say, and don't forget to pay the pastor. And so, you know, that sort of thing. We've got expenses. And I know that's not the most motivating thing to hear to give. But listen, in order for us to be able to do ministry, it requires money. And, you know, it's not like we have this endowment somewhere that we can draw from. It's the way that keeps us alive. It keeps us moving here. Obviously, the presence of the Lord, but your faithfulness and your generosity. And so I just pray continue to do that. It keeps Tina and I in a place where, you know, we're able to stay locked into a time of seeking the Lord and praying and getting a word from God and being able to come and to teach and instruct. And here's what we're doing now. We're actually going to be spending way more time with everybody, not in a large group setting. We're unable to do that, but we're just going to break it down and we're going to start meeting in small groups here throughout the week. And there's some we're working on those logistical things, and you guys are a big part of that. And so what I need you to do, if you're interested in getting a group of people together that you're comfortable with and you want to come here to the church, which this is where I want to meet you at, we just want to encourage you to come and bring a group of people. No more than 10. No more than 10. We're going to keep it 10 and smaller. And Tina and I are going to just be meeting with those groups, fellowshipping. We're going to be really just teaching and discipling you to the best of our ability as the Lord leads us. But we don't want to ask anybody else to do that right now. We want to do that. We feel it's very important and critical for us to be connected to all of you and to give you a chance to get to know us on a whole nother level. And so we're going to be moving forward and doing that here throughout the week, because the whole Sunday morning thing is just, it's been a very, very daunting task. Even everything that we've done the last few weeks, it's been very daunting. You know, and some of the reports that we're hearing from different people, you know, we have people that attend our church that work for the health department of Baltimore and things like that, and just listening to their wisdom on that, and then, you know, other churches in the area, this COVID thing is real, And it's affecting people in a very real way. And part of my apprehension and trepidation about opening it up is the more you do that, with at least the volunteers that are here on a consistent basis, it exposes us and their kids to the possibility of you know, spreading this disease around. And I just don't want to, I don't want to preach anybody's funeral here because of COVID, all right? And so if there's a way to mitigate that and control that, then we want to make sure that we're doing that. And so, you know, we're kind of going to be steering away from even what we've been doing the last few weeks here and allowing you to pre-register and come and all of that. We're still going to be, you know, live streaming. I think our worship team, I'm going to meet with them after the service today and talk with them about, you know, where we want them to be and doing. But as far as the, even with the registering of people and having them come in, we just felt like that, you know, even though nobody here has COVID, we haven't had any scares or anything like that, praise be to God. But I don't want to risk it. I just don't want to take that chance. But that being said, it's still hypercritical for y'all to be connected to us and as a church family. I don't want to just rely solely on live stream, although I'm grateful for it. I just don't want to depend on that to be the way that we connect. I don't want to just depend on that to be the way that we disciple, although I'm thankful for it. I don't want that to be the only way. And so, you know, part of the recommendation from the CDC is meet in smaller groups. And so we're doing that. We're meeting in smaller groups, and we're going to meet here, and we'll be able to practice the social distancing and all of that. But at least it gives me an opportunity to be face-to-face, even if it's 6 feet apart, face-to-face with anybody who is willing to come. And you know, we're going to, this is wild, but, you know, you guys are going to get to dictate the majority of what that calendar and what that schedule is going to look like, you know, because I've got a lot of things to say. I told Dwayne before I came up here, I said, good news, I've narrowed the sermon down to 4, maybe 5. When it gets to 2, I'll go up on the platform. And so I'm still on 4, but, you know, I felt like I better get up here. And so, but I have a lot of things to talk about. I have a lot to say. I have, my spirit is stirred so deeply. And really, Sundays just isn't for me. Just, you know, even live streaming doesn't always get the job done for me. And so I thought, man, how great would it be just to, you know, meet with you and your families? You know, some of you have larger families, some of you smaller, and you there, but there's people that you've been connected to and that you feel comfortable being with, that you know that you've been practicing the same type of distancing and hygiene and all of that. And there's people that you've been used to being around that you're not worried about catching COVID off of them. Then grab those people and come and meet with me and Tina here. And we got a great staff here that's gonna make sure all the rooms have been prepared and sterilized and cleaned and all of that. And so this is, you know, it's gonna help us mitigate this COVID, but it's also gonna keep us very well connected. And so what you'll need to do is, let's see, Liana says on August 30th, on Facebook, our Riverside app, and on CCB, those of you that are members of the church here, or church family here, you know what CCB is. That's our database. You'll be able to register for those classes and or those gatherings, those smaller gatherings, and there'll be drop downs and all that. And so I want to encourage you to go to that. All right, everybody, I want to encourage you to go to that. And there'll still be a registration that you'll do, but it's to help us to determine what works best for all of you guys. And then the meetings are going to kick off officially. They've been unofficial. I met with several groups last week, just kind of impromptu, which are great. And I'm meeting with some even this week. But officially, we'll kick them off the week of September the 16th. That'll be official. Unofficially, we're kind of meeting with people now as well. Those of you that have kids and young people, you got teenagers, guess what? Bring them with you. Put them in the room with you. I love kids and I love young people, and they need to learn. They need to be a part of it. And I want to be the one that gets to pour into them and let them ask questions. Let them engage with us. And I just want them to be a part of it as well. We're going to ask that everyone, you know, continue to follow all the mandates and all the rules that we kind of have set forth here to make sure that you're not sick and that you're not having symptoms and all of that. We're going to do social distancing, and there's still a form that you filled out. I think it's the same one that you filled out to come into here today. We'll do temperatures and things like that. The plan is to try to have all the meetings here at the church because we have a property that's paid for, a building that's paid for, and we're having to pay the utilities on it, and we're having to, you know, cut the grass and keep everything looking nice here. It sat empty here for 6 months, and I think that's a tragedy. I don't want to do that anymore. Let's take advantage of it. God blessed us with it. Let's use it. Amen? And so we want to do that. If you have any questions, any comments about that, you can always email the office at the email address is office@rcclife.com, or you can call the office here and leave a voicemail, and one of our staff will get back with you and kind of help you with that. Again, there'll be more information coming out. We're going to just overwhelm you and inundate you with all of that information about how to stay connected and keep connected. And so I think that's everything. That's all the hard work.